went through so much character development, and that was due to the fact that this year was just a roller coaster. And I wanted to share everything that I've learned with you guys. This is going to serve as like a personal benchmark video for me as well. I know that it is incredibly easy to victimize yourself and think that the entire world is out to get you. I'm like the leader of self-deprecation and self-wallowing. Like, that used to be my shit. I used to do that all the time. I would make up so many excuses as to why I couldn't do this or that, or why I shouldn't do something. But in reality, I was just freaking scared, and I made up so many excuses to kind of hold myself back. I would always say like, oh, you know, I'm not good enough, or I'll never be able to do this or that, and really just pick out all my weakest traits and qualities and use that as a deterrent to not give myself that chance. So the moment that I kind of flipped the narrative around and I told myself, you know what, this self-pitying isn't going to get you anywhere, that was when I felt like I had more control over my life. The moment I realized that I had to flip my negative mindset around, that was when I started to grab for opportunities left and right. I wasn't 100% confident about them. I did it anyways, and the reality is that you can never be fully prepared for anything. So rather than just wait around and hope for the day that you'll be super prepared, just go out and do it, because honestly, it's just do it. Now, growing up, I used to read and write a lot, but in the back of my head, I always felt like it was super unproductive because I didn't serve any kind of monetary purpose, and I wasn't good enough to necessarily make money off of reading, and I wasn't good enough to make money off of my really mediocre writing. After a certain age, you're kind of forced to give up on certain things because, number one, you're not good enough to really pursue it professionally. Number two, you don't have enough time because life gets in the way. I was so far up capitalism's ass that I thought just doing anything for the sake of wanting to do it, or because I really enjoy doing it, was not a good enough reason. I really thought that every hobby of mine was invalid because it didn't serve a further or monetary purpose. So let this be a PSA to tell you guys that you should go pick up that fantasy book that you've been meaning to read, or to finish knitting that rug that you've been putting aside for the longest time. Which actually leads me to today's sponsor, Skillshare. The timing of this was impeccable. I was going to sign up for an account anyways, so the fact that this sponsorship came in clutch, perfect. Skillshare is an online learning community that has over thousands of courses, perfect for any creative and curious individuals out there that are learning to pick up new skills and just brush up on their knowledge. I am halfway through the creative writing course by Roxane Gay, who is known for her many works, including Difficult Woman, which I actually read and loved. So I was super excited to see that she had a course up on Skillshare. I'm like halfway through it, and I'm enjoying it so much because I actually used to be really into creative writing back in high school. I'm really excited to get back into it and kind of a brush up on my skills. I love how every step is just broken down. She gets straight to the point. There's no fluff, and that's what I really appreciate in a course. For a limited time, you guys can use my code in the description box below to get a free trial of Skillshare's premium membership. If there has been one thing that COVID has taught me, to not take little things for granted. Oh gosh, if I could just go back in time and just go to that one restaurant, that one cafe one last time. Even just simple things in my routine now, I really look forward to them. And I think that's just one of the things that I'm super mindful of right now, to just be completely present and to really soak in my environment and just pay attention to so many things that I didn't really care for before. You know that one quote that's supposed to be super inspiring, and I swear I see it on like every cheesy ass motivational account where it's like, oh, you have the same 24 hours as Bill Gates, go out there and do amazing things, blah blah blah, something like that, something along those lines. Whenever I see something like that, I just get so annoyed, because I know its intentions is to make you, like, you know, work harder and be more motivated. Those quotes kind of give you that false perception that we all have the same kind of access to the resources that these millionaires have. We all have the same kind of mindset, lifestyle, brain functions, blah blah blah, and all these other crazy things. Just please stop this madness right now. I was like in this very rough state where I was just constantly comparing myself to a bunch of people around my age because I felt like these past two years, I've just been at home, frozen in time because I wasn't really doing anything. I was changing as a person, you know, growing up emotionally and like mentally, going towards the end of my uni career, but then my environment wasn't changing. And because of COVID, you know, it's almost impossible to really do anything new. And then I would see videos of people moving out, living their life, renting out an apartment for the first time. And I was like, damn, I wish that could be me. I'm not able to really move out because it's not a viable financial option for me. I just really have to remind myself sometimes, like, you know what, this is not the norm and we shouldn't really enforce it to be the norm because that really just paints a very toxic and false reality. Not everyone is able to move and live on their own and be able to support themselves at such a young age. And we shouldn't think that just because there's so many young people out there that are able to do so, it doesn't mean that this is a reality for everyone. It's so crazy to know that even though comparison is one of the most toxic things that we can do, everyone does it on a daily basis, whether you are aware of it or not. And I think I still do on a daily basis, but it's gotten way less toxic. One thing that I've realized is that when you get in that toxic mindset, it's very, very hard to get out of that rabbit hole. Now, I know it's not easy to just go from comparing yourself every day to people to just completely stopping. Here are some things that I want you guys to consider the next time that you feel yourself slipping into that old habit. Number one, we all have different circumstances, upbringings, situations, mental capabilities, physical capabilities. So to compare yourself to someone else is kind of ridiculous. It's almost like comparing two different books from two completely different genres and expecting for it to have like the same sort of outcome and review and conclusion, you know? Like, it just doesn't make sense no matter how you want to put it. Number two is to just stop focusing on your negative qualities. Start looking at the positive ones and how far those have gotten you. You know, I think we just got to stop dwelling on those negative things because that just makes you blind to the things that you are really good at. Once you think you're doing better than one person, you're just gonna find another person to compare yourself to. So it's this never-ending long game that you're just never gonna win no matter how badly you want to. For the longest time, I didn't really realize that gaslighting was something that you could actually inflict upon yourself. And for those of you that don't know what the definition is for gaslighting, Google actually says that it's when you manipulate someone through psychological means into questioning their sanity. So this is when they like plant seeds of doubt into your head to question your perception and your judgment. So it's like this very subtle way of emotional abuse, I guess you could say. I've been through my fair share of knowing people that gaslights others, and I've also experienced that being inflicted on me, but I never really knew how much it has come out of myself. This year, I've realized how I'm constantly gaslighting myself like no tomorrow. I feel like I'm my own worst critic, which makes sense because no one knows you as well as you do, and you're aware of all of your flaws, and you're that one person that's constantly there by yourself. Side all the time. So you're gonna see everything, the good and the bad. There would be so many moments that I would just kind of question my self-worth, my capabilities, my skills, everything. And then this is when I realized, like, okay, I gotta stop doing this because if I don't want other people talking about me in this way, I have to stop talking to myself like that. Enough is enough, Jasmine. Get a grip, get a hold of yourself. I deal with imposter syndrome all the time and just self-esteem issues. So it's a lot to really deal with on a day-to-day basis, but we're working with it, you know? Like, we just gotta deal with it. I used to think that I was the kind of person that was super naive for always trying to look on the bright side of things because I surrounded myself with a lot of cynical people, and for the longest time I used to associate that with being more realistic about one situation rather than like, damn, they're just being negative. And I used to feel like, oh, you know, because I'm always so optimistic and positive no matter what kind of situation I'm in, maybe that just means that I'm naive and not necessarily like the smartest, because some situations are actually so bad, but I still try to find like that silver lining. I just had it stuck in my head for the longest time. Being this way meant I was foolish because I didn't did have a couple of people kind of comment on like, oh, you know, why are you always like so positive? Like, this is actually a really dire situation. That made me kind of like reevaluate everything. But then over time, I was like, wait a damn minute. There's nothing wrong with being positive and being optimistic, because there's been so many moments where my optimistic personality has come in clutch and saved me from so many situations and helped me not down spiral. It has allowed me to get up a lot faster whenever I'm faced with a sense of failure. I realize, like, you know what, this is not that big of a deal, it's whatever, and I just look at the positive side of things, like, you know what, we're all dying anyways, so just don't be a bitch about everything and just take it as it is. Rejection is everywhere, even when you don't see it up front, which is why like hate comments don't really bother me as much as they used to. I find that people that are super insecure are always the first ones to point out anything, like any flaws, things that they find wrong or whatever. Once you realize that those people are constantly projecting their insecurities and flaws on you, that's when you learn to really not give a fuck about what they say, because it's almost like, why do you care so much about this certain issue? Or why do you feel the need to always point it out every time, even though it's not that big of a deal? It really gets you thinking. For example, I used to know a couple of people that would constantly judge others for how they would act, what they would wear, how their makeup was done. And then over time, I realized, like, you know what? These are the people that are actually trying their hardest to fit in. And those were actually the people that were super, super insecure with themselves. And they were always just constantly projecting on other people. Some people can't help it, and I feel like we all end up doing it at one point or another, but some people don't really realize how much comes from them rather than the other person. And that's just another way to say, like, you know, don't care too much about what other people are saying. Most of the time, it really just comes from their own insecurities and own issues. Nothing about you, it's on them. I just had to move my camera from where I was filming before because I ran out of storage space. I deal with anxiety, and I often feel like I sometimes put a hamper on my potential because I can't see past my anxiety. I've come to look at it in a way where my weakness is a part of myself rather than I am my weakness. So it's more in a way where you're phrasing it like I have anxiety rather than I am an anxious person. So the main difference here is that you're listing it as one of your traits rather than making it like an overarching thing. It's not the only thing that you have, and you're way more than that. There would be days where I would just let my anxiety consume my entire being, and I would not be able to look past that for some reason. And now I think I've just sort of reached a stage where I know how to live with it, I know how to cope with it, and I understand it a lot more than I used to. There's no need to really frame it in a negative connotation because it isn't a negative trait. I don't care what anyone says, anxiety, depression, whatever it is that you may have, it's not a negative thing. It's just a part of who you are. I feel like a lot of this year really consisted of me looking towards the future rather than focusing on what I'm doing in the present, and in a way that made me extremely unhappy because I would always be thinking about, oh, what can I be doing right now to work towards where I want to go in the future? And it was always just about, oh, you know, what's next? What's going to happen in like a month from now, a year from now, whatever. And it was never about what's going to happen today, what's going to happen during this week. It was always like, what can I do to make my future situation better? I feel like that's just an inevitable and primed way of thinking, because growing up, you were always sort of told to prepare about what to do next. Like, where do you want to go for school? What courses do you want to take? What job do you want? And a lot of our younger years is just priming us towards the things that we're going to have in the future. Kind of sucks to know that our entire life, we're constantly working towards things that we'll have in the future rather than appreciating what we have now. This never-ending drive to always be worried about the future just made me super, super unhappy, especially with our current situation. There's been so many like 10-year plans and everything that's been ruined because nothing is what you expected it to be. And I feel like sometimes when you look too far into the future, you're almost sort of setting yourself up for disappointment. Not that I'm saying that it's bad to be prepared, because, you know, I'm the kind of person where I love being prepared, but when you prepare too much, I feel like that's also a bad thing because you're also setting these expectations and standards, and then when you don't reach them, that's when you really start to get upset and sad. There's so many other factors that are involved, and sometimes it's way out of your control. I'm telling you right now that no one actually knows what they're doing. And I feel like society as a whole has really just been trying to push this whole thing of like, if you don't have a 10-step plan, you're basically doomed to fail, or you should always know what you're doing every step of the way. And I just know from experience and from everyone that I'm friends with, no one really knows what they want to do. And it's always this constant roller coaster of just thinking you know what you want to do one second, and then the next second, you don't really know. So it's always like this up and down thing. See, the thing is, I love organizing my day-to-day schedule. I love planning out what I like to do, but then I also don't really like planning out my whole career path. I know some people plan out everything to a T, and they basically envision like this whole 10-year plan for where they want their life to go. I know a lot of people that have studied one subject in college, and then they end up doing something completely opposite of that when they enter the workforce or just 20 years down the line. So it's always very, very interesting. And I feel like there shouldn't be one definite thing that defines who you're gonna be for the rest of your life, because that puts so much pressure on yourself, and life is never that cookie cutter perfect. For example, I had this friend that was in her final year of her university program, but then at the last second she decided to switch out and pursue something else. So that meant that she was gonna start from first year all over again in her new program at her new university. And I remember just being on a call with her, and she was telling me about all of her worries and stresses and just feeling like a failure because she wasn't able to really hit all of her milestones and goals that she had planned out originally. Anything that she achieves now won't even be worth mentioning because she's way older, and for some reason accolades and all these other things are only worth mentioning when you're young. And to me, that is just sort of messed up. She just kept on stressing the whole fact that she felt like a failure and she just didn't have her life together anymore. The thing is, I just don't feel like anything is really a waste of time because you still gain so much out of it. All of your life experiences, all those friendships, all those memories. And the thing is, you experience that one thing that really made you realize that this is what you don't want to do anymore. So imagine if you didn't do that thing, then you never would have came to this realization that you're at right now. So it's better to know for sure that this is what you don't want to do than constantly doubt yourself and think like, you know, should I have went into this? Should I not have? I'm one of those people that feels like everything happens for a reason. One door closes and another opens. I know that some people think it's super corny and like cheesy to say that, but I swear that's exactly how it is. There's just been so many things that I've experienced in the past that has led me to where I am today and made me realize so many things that have helped me along the line that made me really go like, it's like the universe put this trauma in front of me so I could learn something from it and be prepared for next time. So that's why I'm just like, everything happens for a reason. Anyways, that's pretty much it for this video. I feel like I've just been rambling for like the past 20 minutes or so. I mean, I don't even know how long this video is gonna be. I hope that you guys were able to take some things away from this. I feel like I often save these for my podcast, and if you guys didn't know, I do have a podcast. I haven't updated it in like a month, and I have a very good reason for that. It's just because I've been super busy, so that's why I haven't been able to update it. If you'd like to hear any of those thoughts in detail, you can go over to any of my existing podcast episodes, because I do talk a little bit more about my own personal experiences with some of the topics that I've mentioned. So feel free to check it out. You know, it's always there for you. Bye.